Welcome to another episode of Hope Without Sight with your host, Sailor Cooper and
Tyler Evans.
Welcome to episode 10.
Hey, all right.
And of course, today we are at Parkapalooza and we have a very special guest, Ray Comeau. Ray, I want to ask you this. Are you pot of pooped yet?
Woo! That's a different question.
I know. I know it's different because a lot of people, especially at the end, will be pot of pooped. Honestly, I'm kind of pot of pooped. I don't know about you, Tyler.
Not yet. No, I'm meeting interesting people is never. No. Bothering, never tiresome, never. It's a new experience, Sailor.
But it has been a long day, you know, sitting in front of a computer screen, you know. At the end of the day, you're very tired, you know. That's how I would be part of pooped, you know. But, yeah. You know, it's well worth it. And it's well worth it, right?
Yes, sir.
Oh, yeah. Yes, it is. So, okay, so let's get started. This is the Hope Without Sight podcast, where me and Tyler interview people who've overcome life's challenges and have come out on top. And our target audience is people who are at such a low point in life and you don't see a way out. So, your talk title is Don't Ever Cross the Line. What comes to my mind is maybe don't overdo it in life. You know, don't overdo it with your business where you're so stressed out.
Yeah.
Is that what you mean?
Yeah. Mine, don't cross the line means don't do anything bad. Okay.
That's very okay. Wise too. Don't do anything bad. That's for sure.
Lying, bullying. So.
So give me the background of yourself. What? You're an entrepreneur. You're business. What?
Actually, for 34 years, I cleaned houses and offices. Okay. Then nearing retirement, I was given a calling, two callings. One to let me know that he's here, believe in me. And the other one was to write a book. So, and now it's taken 5 years. When you talk about the hardship of life, of doing things, when I was 50 years old, I found out that I have ADHD, attention deficit hyper disorder. With that, and trying to write a book has been a very long 5 years, and still, I fight focusing every day. So that's my little, you know, part of my what's happened to me in my life. At the age of 12, I watched my mother on a Friday night plead that God would take her life, and she had passed away on Sunday. At 16 years old, I found out I was adopted. Okay. So there's a lot of, but which some things they should bother you, but if you've been raised good. So, the ADHD that bothered me because it answered so many questions I had of what the problems I had in my life before then. So I was listening to a talk show radio. Okay. And they were talking about ADHD, and I said, or ADD. And I said, what is that? And I listened, and they said, if you have six of these eight things, chances are you have ADD. And I said, I said yes to almost eight of them. And I realized what happened, and I pulled over, and I cried for an hour in the car, all by myself, thinking about what I just listened to, and all the answers, all the problems that I had. And the answers came boom, 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 boom to me as to what had happened to me. And I, 2 weeks later, I was tested. And I found out I had ADHD, the hyper disorder. So you take it in stride. Okay, Sailor, Tyler, you take it in stride. There's things that happen.
Yeah, right, because honestly, I can relate. I have ADHD too, to some degree. And when I was diagnosed, like I had trouble like accepting it because there's just a stigma out there that ADHD, oh, it's just one thing. It's about having bad behavior and doing bad, terrible stuff. When it's not that. I mean, there's different levels of it.
Yeah.
For instance, the ADHD that I have is sometimes staying organized, you know, from getting motivated in the morning. Sometimes I'll get up, I'll be just, you know, fidgety, you know, groggy. I just can't start a task.
Yeah.
Stay on task.
Mm-hmm.
And I get sidetracked easy.
Mm-hmm.
I won't complete a task and start another one without completing the first one. And sometimes impulsivity, like, it's a common symptom too. You know, I'll say stuff too soon.
Oh, yeah.
And cut people off.
Yeah.
And, you know, I don't know about you. I mean, if you want to share, you can, but I do take medication for it. I've taken a few stimulants. I mean, as you know, most of the stimulants can, like, have other side effects along with them, such as the, you know, increased anxiety. And I take one called Foglin. It's one of the best ones that I've taken. And it has one of the least side effects. And I'm happy with that. But it does really help me stay focused whenever I need to take it. And man, I mean, when you find out you had ADHD, I mean, you were like, what? Yeah. You know, you didn't know what to do. You started crying. You know, I hear you. It's a fear of what people are going to say. And, you know, that's why people need to be educated more and understand about people and not be afraid, because just like anything, it can be managed and controlled. So
how many people tell you, Joe, I took a pill and it went away? They thought it was like an aspirin, you know. Oh, I took a pill and it, you know, ADD went away. No.
Yeah, exactly. So you wrote a book. How long did it take you to write this book?
5 years.
And what's the book called and what's it about? And I know, Tyler, I know you're going to have questions about it as well, because we're trying to write a book together, right?
Yeah, it's hard. What bad we do, don't ever cross the line. There's a line in our life that we shouldn't cross. We shouldn't steal from somebody, okay? We shouldn't go across the line because of the color of somebody's skin, because of religion, because of indifference, because we feel bad about something, or we want to sell drugs, okay? People cross the line all the time to sell drugs, okay? They need money.
Right.
They don't want to work. They want to retire tomorrow, so they decide to sell drugs. How many lives are ruined by crossing that line, okay? Millions. Millions. My book is a message, okay? It needs to get out there. With 20 years ago, this book would have been, yeah, okay. Today, what's going on in our world, this book is needed now. There's no slowdown. There's no slowdown over the next 5 or 10 years. What's going on all around the world? There's human trafficking, okay? Abuse of authority. George Floyd was killed because of abuse of authority. The priests, okay, that overdid it and sexually assaulted so many kids. Abuse of authority. You don't punish God. You don't punish the whole police system. You punish the individual, okay?
Yes, you do. Yes, you do.
Exactly.
And I do believe that justice needs to be served when people cross the line. I mean, I understand people have power, but when they cross the line, you know, they need to be held accountable for their actions.
Yeah, but... But today we compromise. We want to move the line. Oh no, that's too crowded for me. I want to move the line. I want to be able to do what I want to do. No. The line is the line. That's it. There's no bending it. Excuses. You stop a kid and that is doing something wrong, and it'll say, oh, he'll think of 10 different excuses to come up with because he's numbered them, because he knows how to get out of it. So he's got an excuse. There is no excuse. All right. Claim responsibility. All right, claim responsibility.
Yes, indeed. Claim responsibility. Yeah. So what have you done with this book? Have you made money off of it? Have you sold it?
No, no, no. It will be published the end of November.
Oh, yeah, awesome.
And, oh, please, and finally.
What's the book called? Don't Cross the Line?
No, What Bad We Do.
What Bad We Do. Okay. Awesome, awesome, awesome.
I have a second book coming out next year also. I'm not going to write that one. I'm going to get a ghostwriter to write that one. This one was too hard. This one, Why We Do the Bad We Do.
Wow. And what's the second one going to be about?
Excuses, compromising, negative euphoria, greed, anger. How much anger we have now today? We have so much anger. And we do
And that's right. So much hate in this country's divisive. I mean, exactly. We don't need that. We need to be civil in this country. In the world, too.
Yeah, it's hard. It's hard. Sailor, Tyler, it's hard today. We make excuses for everything. All right. We want to be rich tomorrow. I don't want to. I don't want to work all my life. Okay, I want to retire tomorrow. No. We each have to do our diligence. If you come up with a good idea and you can make money with it, well, that's fine. But don't steal. Don't take from somebody. Don't hurt somebody. Don't figure out a new way of, the stuff now the stealing from telephone. Okay. Everybody's come up with different ideas to scam. Okay. Scamming. Everybody wants to scam somebody. They don't see the face. They just take the money and they don't have to worry about the hurt that they're causing.
Right? Exactly. Yes.
Yeah.
Yes. And I mean, Ray, you were wise beyond your years, man.
I'm 74. I don't know about beyond my years. Like, who knows? maybe God just waited until I had enough sense, to talk about things like this. Okay.
Exactly. So message. What other business ventures have you had besides writing this book?
Right now, nothing. This is it. I'm in two other books. Business, Life, and Universe by Corey Poirier. It's an anthology book. I have a chapter in there. That's a international bestseller. He has another one coming out, number 8. So I got a book with Ray Brem. He's a big author, editor, publisher. I have a book coming out with him. So trying to write as much as possible. There's so much to write about today.
Throughout all your years, what have you done besides write these books?
I mentioned before, I cleaned houses and offices.
So you clean houses and offices for
34 years. 34
years. Wow, my goodness.
Go from that and to be a writer. So something has to be divine about that. The message that I got, the calling.
Wow. That's one. And wow. And that calling to be a writer. What are your goals for the future after you publish these books?
More writing. Don't let my wife know.
Don't let your wife know. Okay, I see. Well, Ray, I know we're limited on time, and I know I have another interview to go to in the next 10 minutes, so I know we need to make this quick. Do you have any questions for me, or even your Tyler? Do you have any questions for Ray?
Let's see. What inspired you to go from cleaning houses to writing?
Well, the calling, Tyler.
Okay, cool.
I'll tell you, he came down. I asked him I needed a favor. I needed a sign, not to do something, to buy something. And I needed to make a phone call at 5 o'clock on a Friday, and 4:30 in the afternoon, right there in front of me, were the words "Believe in me." It was right there. You sit back and you think about it. The brush in my hair on my arms. Did I see that? Did I see that? And it took me a couple of minutes, and I said, I realized I saw it. I saw that it was there, and I thanked him for 5 years. And that 5 years later, I got my second calling to write a book. And it was writing the book was 1 week after I retired. So he didn't wait. He knew I needed time. So that's why the distance of the 5 years. He knew I wasn't ready. So when I retired, there was things I wasn't going to do anymore. I came down here to Costa Rica, and boom, he gave me this sign to write a book. And he's given me a number of signs since then. So I've been blessed in a lot of ways, besides my wife.
Good deal. Besides your wife's been blessed too. I see.
Yes.
You've been blessed. I mean, everybody has a blessing. We all have challenges. All of us do, like me and Tyler have visual challenges.
Mm-hmm.
We're blind.
Yeah. If you're looking for,
we all have a gift, and we all have callings in life.
Yeah. Oh, yeah. No, it comes. He talks to you. Okay. He does talk to everybody. It's a question of whether you're listening.
Well, if you don't have any more questions for me, Ray, I want to close out by asking. I ask everybody on the podcast.
Mm-hmm.
Anybody who's struggling out there, who can't see a way out, what advice would you give to them? What is your message?
I hear the actor, the black actor, always says, if you fall down 7 times, you get up 8. Always keep getting up.
Oh, yeah, that is so wise, so wise. Oh, if you fall down, get back up again, because you will succeed. You will succeed. That's right.
That's right.
Yes, you will definitely, totally succeed. Well, Ray, I want to thank you so much for being on the Hope Without Sight podcast. Are we having fun at Pagapalooza?
Yeah.
Yeah.
What a pleasure for me, guys. Okay.
Yes, you too. I want to thank you. So I want to thank Kimberly and Michelle for their tireless effort to make this all possible. And of course, Ray, I want to share my email, my contact, so you can please send me, the books.
Okay. We'll be in the chat.
Well, everybody, give it up for Ray Comeau on Hope Without Sight, episode 10.
Thank you, guys. Thank you very much.
We hope you feel renewed, inspired, and encouraged, like you can just carry on and conquer the world.
Please hit the subscribe button on all platforms and tell your friends and family to do the same.
Blessings to all.